If you've ever tried to learn iOS app development, you might have found yourself overwhelmed with the number of principles, concepts, and frameworks that you had to learn. And on top of that, each year, Apple introduces new APIs and new frameworks into the mix. It's tough to keep up. But having said that, here are five timeless iOS development topics that beginners should learn. Number one, the Swift programming language. Now, this is the code that you write to express your app logic, such as what should happen when the user taps on a button on the screen. Swift powers all of Apple's platforms, including iOS, iPadOS, macOS, watchOS, and so on. Having a basic understanding of Swift is a great start, but as you get deeper and you learn more about things like optionals, closures, protocols, generics, and that sort of stuff, you're going to be able to express your intentions that much better through your app. To get started, you can read the Swift programming language guide, or you can watch our free masterclass on Swift Basics for Beginners. Number two, SwiftUI. Now, SwiftUI is the code that describes the user interface for your app. The SwiftUI framework contains user interface components such as buttons, toggles, sliders, but not only that, it also contains layout containers and groups that let you describe how these components should be arranged on the screen. The great thing about SwiftUI is that it's a declarative framework, meaning that you don't have to describe where every single element should be placed down to the pixel. Instead, you can describe relative to other elements how you want your user interface components to be arranged, and SwiftUI will do its best to arrange it in a layout that is the best experience depending on the screen size that the user is on. To get started learning SwiftUI, we have a 3-hour tutorial on SwiftUI Basics for Beginners. Number three, data flow. Now, after you've got a good handle on Swift and SwiftUI, the next topic is to learn about how data moves through the screens of your app. You might think that you have to write code to manually move data from screen to screen in your app, but in a SwiftUI app, it's actually much easier than that. By learning about concepts such as state, bindings, environment objects, and the combine framework, you can take advantage of SwiftUI and have your views update automatically as the data source changes. Personally, I had to change the way I thought about data flow when SwiftUI came out, but I'm really glad that I did. Number four, navigation and view composition. After you understand data flow in a SwiftUI app, it's not a very big leap to start building multi-screened apps. SwiftUI makes it really easy to arrange the views in your app, such as managing them in a tab bar across the bottom of your app, or perhaps letting the user drill down into your views using the navigation stack. On top of that, composing more complex views out of smaller reusable views is very simple as well. Once you get the hang of managing and composing your views, you'll be able to build bigger and more complex apps. On our channel, we have a video about navigation in SwiftUI. Go check it out. Number five, Apple's human interface guidelines. While Apple releases new APIs and frameworks each year, their guidelines for what makes a great user experience and design don't change as often. In Apple's human interface guidelines document, you'll find best practices for each of their platforms, including common design patterns and guidance around things like dark mode and accessibility. By understanding the core principles and best practices of what makes an app experience on an Apple device, you'll be able to build your app in a way that feels great and looks great, even if you don't have a professional designer or if you're not a designer yourself. Now, if you keep these five timeless iOS development topics in mind as you embark on your own app journey, you'll be building your skills on a solid foundation that will serve you for years to come. To get started, check out our 3-hour iOS development class for beginners. You'll find it right here on YouTube. In those 3 hours, you'll learn skills in all of these five topics we covered today, and you'll have built your very first app. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you there.